Well, ladies and gentlemen, this time I'd like to ask if you'd please stand and remove cover for our invocation to be followed by a presentation of colors and the singing of our national anthem. Let us pray. Father, tonight we come to you thankful for the opportunity to be here and watch such an incredible sport. We're very mindful of the dangers it brings, and with that, we'd like to ask that your hand of guidance be with our Cowboys, but not only them, that you be with our livestock as well. As we come to you this day, I want to say a very special prayer for our servicemen and women. May they be here at home or even abroad, protecting and defending the freedoms we so dearly love as free Americans. We come to you this day very humble. We say thank you for your grace as we ask forgiveness of our sins. In your mighty name, we pray. Amen.
Amen.
I love me some Texas.
Ladies and gentlemen, tonight to present our nation's colors, I'd like you to please welcome retired United States Army veteran Lucas Benson. And ladies and gentlemen, now to sing our national anthem, this is the Sisters.
Casino.
got some bulls here, and Brandon, brand new for this year, the sixth year that we've had the PBR's Iron Cowboy, and this year it is not a bracket style, my man. It is a progressive round format.
Yeah, that's right.
To go on and just like I said, you ride great second, you move on to round number two.
Well, that's right. Don't forget, when we talk about points being the king in the PBR, each one of these rounds will set up a significant amount of points. When the guys finish here, every round, possible of available 100 points.
Well, if you're way back in the back, this, the man you're watching, the very red hot butter Bolton. To play inside the top 35.
Look, when you watch him, and it's funny to me because this is a young man, he's 26 years old. I think it took him this long to join the ranks. The PBR. Make your move. Seven. And how about the kids
of events just like this one? And who just happened to win the 2014 last Cowboy standing? It was Valera May Martin.
Like, it takes some experience, it takes some willpower, strength, determination, and to be able to advance every single round, or be able to continue to ride your bulls and push forward. The guy tonight, by the time it's all said and done, make no mistake about it, will be the most exhausted man in the room.
There is a shot of the bull, Slippery Devil for Wolf Creek Cattle Company. These bulls in this round, I mean, Cody Lambert has done a fantastic job of putting a very good, even pit of bulls for these guys to get on in round number one. Now, the bulls that they're going to meet in round number two, that is a totally different story, and we'll get into that in just a second. Marchi has got a good one underneath him.
Trying to get it right. We'll see this bull battling it. Let's get it. He survived.
That's all that counts. He got it, and we watched the replay back right here, and you know, you can go through here and analyze this, and as you see, Marchi got out of position right there just a bit, and that bull turned back right there, kind of picked him up, but you know, at this point right now, it's all about survival, and that's advancing on to the next round, 83 points.
To take the re-ride to advance, I am watching to see how fast he is moving around down there. What's going on? This bull is not fun. 74 and a half points.
Yeah, Ranger just not having his day. We'll see him in just a second. It's Ben Jones getting set to go for you. The Danes of Australia and back next. Southern Hawaii. Jeff Robinson, Buck Davis, of course, Ben Jones is a guy that has wanted to win this event in this very building for many years. Can he get it done this year? He is. There's the 8-second whistle for Graham.
Well, looking right now for 3 points. Kicks off at 36 in the world, that means he is on the bubble. Remember, there were 40 guys in here. Not to the normal 35 that you'll put up for touch series in a week. Because remember, this is the first PBR major event. 40 athletes coming in. Five of those guys need a spot in the top 35. And you are Skeeter Kingsoff. This is, I'm going to tell you how big I think it is. And some people say, well, you're being and over dramatic, whatever, that's your opinion. This is a career bull ride, because your career is hinging on it right now. 25 years old, time to get back in the game. This weekend, move forward, get some points. Let's do it.
Oh, Frank Newsom. Look at that. Whoa, Jesse Byrne.
Don't make me throw my black hole.
As officially as of right now, going to round number two.
Stanley, the official
Acres. Brandon last weekend. Over in Kansas City, Missouri. Jamie Moody on the sidelines. Decided, you know what? I'm going to stick a weekend off. Trying to get back healthy.
Well, he took a weekend off so he could be here. And he took a weekend off so he could be here. The AT&T American. That's what it's all about for him. And he looks like he refocused his shot right here. Watch him for you. Let's take a look at what this guy's been able to do. The biggest thing that he's got on his side, number one, is talent. Number two, his age. He is 21 years old. And a world of talent. At a very young age, open season, the bull we're going to watch right now from Western Star, a bull company. We've seen this bull a handful of times, Clint, most recently ridden a year ago in Las Vegas.
Yeah, it was a while ago, but Brady Sims, I think you hit the nail right on the head. And what he's got going for him is youth, and it's quite a roller coaster ride this season. It's not going to get any better. I mean, I really thought that he picked up a lot of momentum in Kansas City.
Night is over. Weekend is over. Let's talk about now Nathan Shaw. Highlight reel from Kansas City. This guy was. He was able to step in, have the bull sweep goes long, John.
Thank you.
Lamar Cheeb right there trying to give him a little bit of hand, and Renato taking more time than what he usually does. Good question. Business, buddy.
Yeah, these games for the rebound action. He's got this bull American hustle. Underneath him right now, I'm taking him for some reason.
Yeah, the number three ranked bull rider in the world as of right now. We have 12 men that are advancing in round number two. And let me tell you, the bulls that they will face are hands down, no doubt, you cannot argue with this point, the greatest bulls in the world they will face in round number two. And Reese Cates.
I have to readjust. Jones getting a new position.
High stepping out there. My man.
Hey, did you guys introduce the guys on the horses?
Not yet. No. But you can.
Can I do it?
You have the floor, my man.
Over to my right on that side of the arena, PBR legend, ladies and gentlemen. I think he's from Texas, Mr. Mike White, right there. Mike. To my left, the other of the dynamic duo, world champion, PBR bull rider, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Chris Shivers, right there. On the left.
Speaking of which, those guys are not done. May 30th, Unfinished Business, Decatur, Texas. Pay-per-view PBR event coming to you, and at that event, tickets went on sale for Unfinished Business today. If you did not buy your Unfinished Business tickets, you better hurry.
Yeah, you better.
You're right, because there are a handful of tickets left for that event. Ace Cage. Like you said a moment ago, Clint, number three ranked bull rider in the world. This guy has been very solid this year. 2 wins on the season.
Round one continues. That was Andre Cardoza, himself, the Brazilian bull rider. This boy is making his debut inside the top 40 in the world, and he's sitting 30th right now. Get you set up at the Rocky Mountain Elk Foundation.
Oh, I got that.
Tough. Fearless. Each week, the bullfighters put their lives on the line to protect the bull riders of the PBR. Rocky Mountain Elk Foundation wants to reward their courageous acts with a hunting adventure they'll never forget. Fans, you have a say in which bullfighter wins the RMEF Go-To Guy Award. Go to www.pbr.com/go-to-guy to vote for which Dickie's Dura bullfighter you think made the save of the week each week this season. Not only will the bullfighter win the trip of a lifetime, but one lucky fan will also win a hunting adventure. Compliments of the Rocky Mountain Elk Foundation. Hunting is conservation. The Rocky Mountain Elk Foundation. Ensuring the future of elk, other wildlife, their habitat, and our hunting heritage.
Well, Brandon, this different from that last bull that you saw that just didn't have any timing, and you just really couldn't predict him. But Bruiser does have some timing. I mean, he's going to get up in the air, and he's going to have a lot of kick. Joel has an opportunity to knock one out of the park right here. Let's go! Man, what a huge bull ride. Joel Ricardo Vieira, remember this event last year, a year ago. He was the 2014 Iron Cowboy. He knows how to win in this stadium.
He knows how to win. He's going to jump out here. How about 90 and a half points? 90 points. First 90 pointer of the night. He goes to Joel Vieira. He is able to deal it up. You watch right there. Nicely done.
She put her feet.
You just love that.
That was old school. Shoot the graffiti.
The graffiti.
And the graffiti goes crazy.
Kicking it old school. Repack them, boys. Repack.
Winner here, going to pick up four of the NBA tickets. Next year's event here in Arlington. You can pick your tickets up at the fan club booth.